And welcome to Blessed Frédéric, Ozanam Parish. Thank you for joining us today as we gather with hearts full of gratitude to celebrate God's immense love for us in the Holy Eucharist. We wish to gratefully acknowledge and thank all our dedicated volunteers without whom this Mass and the live streaming of this Mass would not be possible. Please rise.
This Mass is being offered for the repose of the souls of Eugenio Toribio, of Manuel Lina, and of David Diaz. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome once again to our celebration on this, the 30th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Special welcome to those who are joining us virtually and in spirit through the live stream. Before we begin, as always, let us pause for a moment of silence, call to mind our sins, and ask for the Lord's pardon and mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Thus says the Lord, you shall not wrong or oppress a resident alien, for you were aliens in the land of Egypt. You shall not abuse any widow or orphan. If you do abuse them, when they cry out to me, I will surely heed their cry. My wrath will burn, and I will kill you with the sword. And your wives shall become widows, and your children orphans. If you lend money to my people, to the poor one among you, you shall not deal with them as a creditor. You shall not exact interest from them. If you take your neighbor's cloak in pawn, you shall restore it to that person before the sun goes down, for it may be their only clothing to use as cover. In what else shall that person sleep? And if that person cries out to me, I will listen, for I am compassionate. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, you know what kind of persons we proved to be among you for your sake, and you became imitators of us and of the Lord. For in spite of persecution, you received the word with joy, inspired by the Holy Spirit, so that you became an example to all the believers in Macedonia and in Achaia. For the word of the Lord has sounded forth from you, not only in Macedonia and Achaia, but in every place your faith in God has become known, so that we have no need to speak about it. For the people of those regions report about us what kind of welcome we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols, to serve a living and true God, and to wait for his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead. Jesus, who rescues us from the wrath that is coming. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. The Lord be with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, a lawyer, asked him a question to test him. "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" Jesus said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and first commandment. And a second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." The Gospel of the Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. With these words from today's gospel, our Lord invites us to consider how to truly love God with all our heart, soul, and mind. It's something we hear about often enough, but not much is really said about how to really do this, how to love God with all our heart, soul, and mind. And not that this is a definitive answer by any means, but more and more, I'm starting to realize that the key to loving God with all our heart and soul is to first love him with all our mind. In fact, I would say that it's only when we are able to love God with all our mind that we are then able to love him with all our heart and soul as well. But from my experience, loving God with all our mind is one of the most difficult things to do, because our minds are full of all sorts of competing voices, voices from the world, the flesh, and the devil, voices that fill our heads with all sorts of conflicting messages, voices that tell us all sorts of things that are often not true, and voices from our own distorted perception and reasoning. And so loving God with all our mind is an enormous challenge, because often we are not very discerning about what kinds of thoughts and messages we allow to enter our minds and take root there. And often we spend a lot of time and energy fueling the various thoughts and messages that fill our heads. But just as we need to be cautious about what enters our bodies, we need to be cautious about what enters our minds, because what enters our minds can sometimes make its way into our hearts and souls, changing how we live and who we are. Because the gateway to the heart and soul is often through the mind, and the battle between good and evil in the human person really begins in the mind, because what we allow to fill our minds will eventually make its way into our hearts and souls as well. And so it's good and necessary to really consider how the mind plays a crucial role in our lives, because again, what fills our minds has a profound impact on what fills our hearts and souls. There's a great line from Star Wars Episode I, The Phantom Menace, where Qui-Gon, played by Liam Neeson, says to the young Darth Vader, "Always remember, your focus determines your reality." In other words, what you spend all your time thinking about will determine the quality of your character and the quality of your life. I know this from personal experience because I remember as a teenager how I used to consume a lot of messages from music, from movies, and from television, and how I was not very discerning or vigilant about the kinds of messages that I let to occupy my thoughts. And looking back, many of the messages I consumed from these mediums filled my head with all sorts of lies and negativity, because music, movies, television, and now social media are very good at lying to us and filling our heads with all sorts of false and detrimental ideas. But we always have to be careful about what kinds of ideas take root in our minds and what kind of thoughts fill our heads, because our thoughts truly matter, and our thoughts can become sinful and harmful. This doesn't mean that every time a bad thought pops into our heads, we are committing a sin, but it does mean that when we allow a negative thought to fester, to grow, and to thrive in our minds, it can take on a life of its own and eventually infect our hearts and souls as well. And so it's good to be aware of how powerful our thoughts can be, how they can shape one's life and one's character, and how they can do damage to our emotional, mental, and spiritual health. For just as we need to be careful about what we let into our bodies for the sake of our physical health, we need to be careful about what we let into our minds for the sake of our mental and spiritual health. In other words, we have to be vigilant about our thoughts because eventually we become our thoughts, and because ultimately our thoughts define us, and ultimately our thoughts determine our reality. And once again, I know this from personal experience because when my mind is filled with thoughts about God and His goodness, my heart and soul are much more at peace. But when my mind is filled with all sorts of negative things, especially things concerning the world and its affairs, I become anxious and stressed. And so if our thoughts are negative and unloving, we become negative and unloving people. But if our thoughts are positive, loving, and hopeful, we become positive, loving, and hopeful people. Because again, we are our thoughts, and we are what fills our minds. But the good news is that we don't have to be a victim of our own thoughts, because changing our thought process, changing our thinking, is one of the few things we do have control over. When a negative thought enters our head, we don't have to allow it to remain there, to fester and to thrive. This is something that the Lord has really taught me over the years, that I have the power to change my thinking, and that changing my thinking, changing the way I think about the world, myself, and others, can have a profound effect on my well-being and my quality of life. This is why, even though I still have a long way to go, more and more I make an effort to focus on positive, God-centered messages in the media. I still keep myself informed about what's going on in the world, but I try not to dwell on the negative. On the negative, unhealthy messages that seem to saturate modern media. A couple of years ago, I read something from a psychologist who said that in some sense, our brains are wired to focus on the negative around us, because to recognize and focus on negative things in our surroundings would better ensure our survival. But even if this is true, there's a big difference between being aware and savvy about potential dangers around us and obsessing about them. In other words, focusing on the negative may be more natural for us and in some sense more helpful for our survival, but focusing on the positive can make the difference between simply surviving and truly living. And so even though it may take a lot of work and discipline and doesn't come naturally to many of us, making the effort to entertain positive and hopeful thoughts can dramatically transform our lives for the better. This past summer, I had the opportunity to see the extremely popular Barbie movie, which, although it didn't blow me away, had some insightful moments and messages that stayed with me. For example, there's a scene at the beginning of the film where Barbie's having a house party with all the other Barbies and Kens. And one of the Barbies says to the main Barbie, played by Margot Robbie, "This is the best day ever." And the main Barbie responds by saying, "This is the best day ever. And so was yesterday. And so is tomorrow. And so is the day after tomorrow. And so is every day from now until forever." What I like about that about this scene is that it's a great analogy of what life can be like if we make the effort to fill our minds with positive, hopeful, and God-centered thoughts. And I'm not talking about being fake or phony, pretending everything is going great when it's not, but I am talking about focusing on the positive and finding reasons to be hopeful, reasons why today is going to be a good day, not necessarily the best day ever, but the best day possible, because our thoughts are that powerful that they can determine our reality and transform the quality of our lives. And so on this, the 30th Sunday in Ordinary Time, our Lord invites us to examine the thoughts that fill our heads, to be vigilant about what kinds of messages enter our minds and take root there, and to discern whether these messages are truthful or deceptive, positive or negative, loving or hateful, God-centered or self-centered. Because we do have control over our thoughts, and we do have the power to change our thinking. And if our thoughts are not primarily about the good in the world, the good around us, the good in others, and the source of all goodness, God Himself, then not only are we failing to love God with all our mind, we are also failing to love Him with all our heart and soul as well. Amen. Now let us stand and profess our faith together in the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With hearts united in prayer and hope, let us come before our Heavenly Father with all our needs. As we pray, loving God, hear our prayer.
For the church, that all in pastoral leadership may show loving concern to those who come for guidance and help, we pray. That God's peace, which is beyond all understanding, will reign in our hearts, and for the triumph of Mary's Immaculate Heart in all the troubled parts of the world, especially in the Middle East and Ukraine, we pray. For our young people, that they may listen attentively to the Lord's voice in their lives and seek to do His will with courage, we pray. For our parish of Blessed Frederick Ozanam, that our community will continue to grow and thrive, both spiritually and physically, bringing to fruition our mission to build our new church in which to offer glory and praise to God, we pray. For the sick and the suffering, that the Lord may restore them to the fullness of life and health, we pray. For the faithful departed, that they may enjoy eternal rest in God's heavenly kingdom, we pray.
Loving Father, you are our strength and our refuge. Hear the prayers of your people, which we ask in the name of your Son, Jesus. We entrust all our needs and intentions to you through our Blessed Mother as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Thank you. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity may the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might to the praise of your manifold wisdom be manifest as the church. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with their blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with blessed Frédéric Ozanam, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope, and Francis our Bishop, his assistant bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who were pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And now, at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
This week's announcements, the Knights of Columbus will be collecting donations this weekend and the following two weekends, November 4th and 5th and November 11th and 12th. This is to purchase winter coats for children in need. The coats will be distributed to elementary schools in our community. As winter draws near, please consider supporting this very worthy cause. For more information, please see the parish bulletin. This Friday, November 3rd, is the first Friday of the month, and so we're not going to be doing First Saturday Adoration and Confession anymore. We're switching it to First Fridays. So this Friday, November 3rd, will be the first. There will be a Mass upstairs in the chapel. So right here at the high school, upstairs in the chapel, 7 p.m., followed by Adoration and then Confessions. And so this will happen most First Fridays of the year. We will be praying as usual. We come together to pray for the growth of our community and the building of our church. But this next Friday, we'll also be praying for peace in the Middle East and throughout the world. And again, this will take the place of our First Saturday Adoration and Confessions. So it will no longer be on First Saturdays, but on First Fridays. Monday, November 6th at 7 p.m., we will be having a Mass to pray for all our departed loved ones we have lost over the past year or so. This will take place at St. Mark's Church in Stouffville. This is an annual thing, an annual event. We try to do this every year. So if you lost a loved one over the last year or two or maybe three that you would like to pray for, you're invited to come and pray for them at this special Mass. Once again, that's Monday, November 6th at 7 p.m. at St. Mark's Church in Stouffville. Also, November is the month of all souls, so during November, we will be praying for all those names which you like to include in our Book of Life binder. So there's purple sheets for that purpose as you exit the school in the foyer. There's a table in the center there. There's purple sheets available. You can grab one of those, put the names of your loved ones, and then return them to Diane at the desk on the weekend. And again, we'll be praying for all those souls at all Masses throughout the month of November. And for more information about that, please see the parish bulletin. It's time to start thinking about First Communion and confirmation. So registration for First Communion has begun. So if you have a child that is at least 7 years of age and who has not received their First Communion, you're invited to register them for this most important milestone in their spiritual journey. For more information on how to register, please see the parish bulletin. And for those parents whose children are eligible for the sacrament of confirmation, there will be an information session next Saturday, so that's November 4th, here at the high school, St. Brother Andre, from 1:30 p.m. to 3 p.m. So this is just an information session. We're not starting the registration yet. It'll just be to get information about the program and about how to register. So once again, that's a week from today, next Saturday, from 1:30 p.m. to 3 p.m. here at Brother Andre. To RSVP for this meeting, please see the parish bulletin. And next Sunday is the first Sunday of the month. And guess what's coming back because of the first? Coffee Sunday! Woo! Coffee Sunday is back next Sunday, November 5th. There'll be lots of goodies, hot chocolate, coffee, Timbits, and who knows what else. So there'll be lots of goodies next Sunday. We're starting that again. It's win-win for you guys. I know if you're not coming Sundays, you still get to benefit because it'll be a shorter homily. So that's always a good thing. Shorter homily, shorter Mass. Also, there's a baker that we've contacted, and we've asked them to maybe do something for you guys on Saturday, the first Saturday of the month, because you always miss out on Coffee Sundays. So we're going to try to arrange for them to provide goodies for us on first Saturdays of the month. Things you can take with you. You don't necessarily have to eat them here. But anyway, we're working on that. More information about that to follow. And I just want to thank you all for supporting the gala. I know not all of you were able to make it, but I know you were there in spirit and you supported us with your prayers. It was amazing. It was really far exceeded everybody's expectations. In fact, I'm so worried it was so good, it's going to be hard to top this, this in future galas. But we had so much fun, I'm thinking of doing it once a month. What do you think? Yeah, I know, that would kill me and kill all the volunteers too. So no, we're not going to do that, but thank you once again. I'll have information about how much money we actually raised in the next few weeks. We just have to crunch all the numbers once all the expenses get in and do all the math, we'll find out how much we made. And so we'll let you know about that. But thanks again to everybody that was there or that supported us in spirit or through prayers or through donations. And of course, all the amazing volunteers that just really stepped up to the plate and did an amazing job. And I think that's it. Please stand for the closing prayer. Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs, we may one day possess in truth. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth now in the peace of Christ. The Mass is ended. Thanks be to God. Prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Thanks, everyone, for joining us. I'll be handing out nut-free chocolate right after Mass in honor of Halloween. So you're welcome. I just need a couple minutes to change into my costume, but but stick around. There's nut-free chocolates available if you're interested. God bless, and I hope to see you again soon.